So you show me the original intro and the original Torah. Show me.
So
in the original language, it was recorded.
Okay. So
show me, please.
Let's start reading. Let's try to read it.
Adnan,
show me.
Let's start
and read it to me.
Let's start.
I can show you the Quran.
Oh, there we go.
Let's show you the Quran.
Let's establish that you lie.
Let's read it without looking at it.
No. Don't ever put lie. Don't ever put lie in my mouth.
Okay, show me where it says. Show me where it says.
The Quran talks about Torah and you lost.
Show me.
Exactly. Don't against it.
You said it's not preserved.
Exactly.
I said, you say that? Yeah. You said it's not preserved.
Which means we don't have it. Yeah. So if we don't have it,
you don't have it.
Okay, according to what standard are you saying?
Prove it to me that it has been preserved. In Islam, there's a principle. It is a principle. There's nothing that you have to. The proof is on the claimant. So you prove, you believe that it is.
Don't ever touch me again.
You don't know your religion.
Go and show me where it says. Show me the injury in the Torah. Show me.
Watch this. When you open Surah 545. We're gonna die.
Touch me again.
Stop it. Okay. All right. Okay. I'll read.
We're here to debate.
Yeah, but he's trying to attack.
Please, I don't want to talk to you.
So easily debunk him by saying this. Watch this.
No.
Calm down. Let me answer. I am answering.
My question, Daniel.
I am. Listen.
Answer my question, Daniel.
Listen.
So look, this is my question. This is my question.
Then listen.
Listen to my question. I said to you. You said I can't prove that it's not been preserved. Okay.
You can't.
Prove to me it has been preserved.
Wait, calm down.
And then I'll believe.
Go on. Calm down. Adnan,
your friends are.
We have established. No, Jesus is my savior.
Yes.
We have established.
Not your savior.
Adnan, listen. Could you want me to talk?
I'm saying to you, if you say he's a savior, if you say that he's.
Why is he diverting?
Exactly.
Why are you diverting? Tell me why you diverting. Tell me.
You don't have an answer to that.
We have established that you cannot show me from the Quran that the Torah and the Injil are not preserved. We have established that.
Can show you.
Yeah?
Exactly.
Now watch this. No, you can't show me. You can't show me. Surah 5, watch this. Surah 5, this is, I'm going to your authority and then I'm going to go back to my authority to prove that my Torah is preserved. Watch this. Surah 5,
the Torah is preserved.
45, watch.
The Torah and the Injil.
My brother here doesn't want me to talk because he's going to get exposed. Calm down. And in it we have prescribed for them a life for life, an eye for an eye, a nose for a nose, an ear for an ear, a tooth for a tooth. This is what the Quran says about the Torah, Surah 5, 45. Where did the Quran get this from? Let's check the Torah. Exodus.
Don't panic. Let him speak.
Exodus.
Let Daniel speak.
Chapter 21.
Okay.
Can you listen?
No problem.
Let him finish.
Exodus.
Okay, calm down.
Are you going to listen?
Don't worry.
Muslims, stop heckling. And listen.
Quran and Oxford.
Exodus chapter 21, verses 23. But if there are serious injury, you are to take life for a life, eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, hand for a hand, foot for a foot, burn for a burn, wound for a wound, and bruise for a bruise. This is in the Torah. The Quran got this from the Torah, but it's denying its authority, and Adnan cannot show me that the Torah and the Injil are not preserved according to the Quran.
Okay, so it says.
So now, Adnan.
Okay, no. You have your 5 minutes to fame. You done. You
finished.
Adnan,
calm down.
Go ahead. You're not giving me a chance to talk. You're just talking.
I didn't finish.
You have to wait.
I didn't finish.
Be patient.
So the Quran clearly says what Exodus chapter 21 verse 23 says. That's the Torah. Yeah. So my brother here, in humanity, not in faith, in humanity, he says to me, Torah and Injil are not preserved.
The gospel.
According to what authority are you saying? Unless you are the Mahdi or you're Allah yourself, then I'll probably believe you, but you're not. I can see you're a complete human being. So show me in the Torah, and in the Quran, sorry, where my book is not preserved.
Okay.
And by the way, when I'm talking, he's not listening. So he's not going to answer. Watch. Just watch.
Hurry, ask him. What question do you ask?
Okay.
What's the question? Bro, cameraman, bro, what, you on their side as well?
I can debate you.
Why are you debating the cameraman?
You said to me, this is what you said earlier. You said to me, I can't show you in the Quran where it says that it's been it's been preserved or not. Yeah? So I've got the ayat now, yeah? It says,
Can I do the
janazah? Sorry. You called me a liar. Remember,
you called me a liar.
You're next on jizya.
Okay.
You're next on jizya.
It says,
so just take some.
Do you convert that they would believe for you?
Wait, what chapter? You have a law. You have a law to apply jizya.
I'm not talking to you.
Do you have a law to apply jizya?
Why are you?
You're seeking attention. You want attention.
You have a law to apply jizya.
Stop heckling Ali.
Do you want jizya?
He wants attention. Someone give him attention. Adnan, which chapter and verse is this?
Surah Al-Baqarah.
Surah 2, ayah 79. Is it?
You're not in it. No.
Is it? Is it yes or no? Surah 2, ayah 79.
It says,
yes or no? Because I want to read it.
Talk, man.
I want to read it together.
Let me talk.
I want to read it together. Is it Surah 2?
It says, do they convert that they would believe, for you were a party of them, used to hear the words of Allah, and then distort the Torah after they had understood.
While they knowing.
It says, do you convert that they would believe for you, while a party of them used to hear the words of Allah, and then distort the Torah after they had understood it while they were knowing.
Chapter and verse.
Surah Baqarah.
He wants a specific janazah.
Verse.
Give me the verses, bro. Specifically. 279.
I knew
you're
going to
go to 279, and that's going to refute you.
So you knew
your
janazah.
It's going to come back on you.
You're in trouble.
It's going to come back on you. It's funny that you need three Muslims to debate one Christian.
To get one surah.
Yeah, you, one Christian.
Especially the attention seeker.
Are you guys in Trinity now? You're in Trinity now?
I want to hurt you.
Allah, Manat, and Uzza.
That's what it is.
Three idols.
You're heckling and your bad words and your bad speech. You know, let me tell you something. In your Bible, does it tell you to
call
bad names?
I'm not calling you bad names. I'm calling you what you're saying.
No, you call me an idol.
You
call
Surah
53:19. I'm talking about
when you worship idols so much, you think everyone's an idol.
Now, stick with the topic.
Carry on.
I was answering Ali Dawa on Trinity.
So, what I'm saying to you.
Stick with the topic.
So, you said I'm a liar because I can't prove it. I've just proved it to you now. So
well, you're lying again.
Another one.
Wait.
I don't understand. Do you think these people to back you up here? I don't get it.
So it says, woe to those who write the book with their hands and say it is wrong.
Can he speak, man?
Yeah, let him speak. Come on.
See, this is what I'm saying. You're disrespectful, my friend.
I'm not talking.
You're very
disrespectful.
You're justice.
Don't get it. Listen.
Can he speak, man? He's trying to twist it.
No. It's not to disrespect.
So woe to those who write the book with their hands and then say this is from Allah so they may gain a price. Then woe to them with their hands have written and woe to them what they have earned. So you said to me, where does it say that? It says that corrupted, but that's where it says it.
No,
so that's number one. Now, before you said, and now this is where we're going to go with now. I said to you, we believe as Muslims in the what? In all the books that was revealed. And we believe in the final book that was revealed, which is the Quran. Yeah? Which is, and then you used an ayat saying an eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. Yeah. My friend. Even if the Quran does say it, we're saying that the Quran is confirming the books that came before. We're not denying the books that came before. You're the one who's denying the book that, the last book.
Your statements are.
Let's give him a round of applause for the effort, still.
Let me finish with this. Before you call someone a liar, make sure that you know what you're saying. Because you knew already, the ayah already. You said, Surah Baqarah 79. So you're a liar.
You're covering up the truth.
Done.
Good night.
Run away.
Bye-bye.
Come on.
Adnan cannot debate.
carry on.
Adnan cannot debate because he only wants to talk what he wants to say and then he goes away. No.
Surah Al-Baqarah 79 does not say Torah and Injil is corrupted. This is what it says. This is what it says. Muslims are always deceiving and lying in the park. Let's expose it. So woe to those who write the book with their hands and then they say this is from Allah, that they may sell it for paltry gain. So woe to them for what their hands have written and woe to them for what they earn. Where on earth does it say Torah and Injil?
Whoa!
Where?
I'm gonna run away.
Okay.
I'm finished.
He's gonna give information because he can't handle it.
One second. You knew the ayah, you knew the verse, and you touched the prophet.
Every single Muslim quotes this verse deceptively. So I want to show that you are very deceptive, and I'm going to show the truth.
No, listen, let me say something.
Amen. And Jesus is the king.
Yeah.
And Lord.
Amen.
Repent from your Islamic religion.
Let me say one thing. There's a story, yeah, about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he was about a Jew, yeah, and he was talking about the Jew committed adultery. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "In your book, what does it say about the thing for adultery?" And the Jew, he hid his hand, he put his hand on the verse, and he said, "It doesn't say stoning, yeah." And then one of the Muslims that was a Jew before, yeah, he moved his hand and said, "Look, right there it says stoning. Just a minute ago, you done the same thing. You knew the verse in Surah Baqarah, but you tried to hide it."
What are you talking about?
I hit the Quran. So Allah could not save it. I hit the old Quran.
One second. When Allah says, it's between me and him. Don't worry, because it's a mass burial today. You know why? Because it's night night for you, brother, when I come in to see you.
When you say night night, it does not mean it's night night.
That's why you don't let me speak.
Adnan!
Bye bye!
Adios, amigo! Nine! Adios!
You make it sound ridiculous.
Okay, go on.
He goes, ad hominem. Only doing his personal
stuff. Yeah, but I'm
he's in the debate. You make Islam look
where
bad.
Is he? Where is
your check is this. Brother, I don't care. Okay, Ali, I'm a guy, bad guy, I'm ugly.
The debate started with Adnan, not Ali. This guy heckled him. He heckled
him.
Here you go, yeah? Okay. He goes, where does it talk about the people of the book, the Kitab? Okay. So woe to those who write the book. When Allah refers to the book, what comes to mind? When we hear the book, when we hear, when Allah says, the people of the book, who's Allah talking about?
Okay, Ali Dawa. Ali Dawa.
Brother, one word, night night.
Ali Dawa.
Ali Dawa.
You said you're going to show me the tafsir. You didn't. Yeah?
Look at this guy.
You didn't read the tafsir.
What does book say? What does it mean?
Sir.
What does it mean?
People of... Okay, watch this, yeah? People of the book and then book are not the same thing. Yeah?
Nice try.
People of the book means Jews and Christians. So, in his own standard, yeah? If book means Jews and Christians, why does Surah 5:47 talk about the Quran as the book?
Okay, one second.
Oh.
So, are you telling me one second?
So,
that's
it. So the Quran is corrupted. Exactly.
Knowing what you're
saying. Exactly.
Wait, before I go on.
Exactly.
This is Surah 15:19-19. I am gonna stick to it. According to him, if the Quran says the Torah and the Injil are corrupted, they're corrupted. You have to stay consistent. If the Quran says the Quran has been torn into pieces, then the Quran is torn into pieces.
Yes.
Let's read what it says. Surah 15, ayah 90. Even as we sent down on the dividers, Surah 91, who reduced the Quran into pieces.
Oh.
So is the Quran in pieces now?
Is that supposed to be like a...
No, it's not.
Because you didn't get
I'm serious.
That.
I don't need to get any of that.
Whoa.
So is the Quran in pieces?
Whoa.
Okay. Is the Quran in pieces?
Okay. Exactly.
But I'm giving you two
points.
The
only thing that's in pieces is you right now. Okay.
You have not said anything. How can you be in pieces?
3 months.
How can you be in pieces? You have not said anything.
Anyway,
Islam is pieces.
Guys, he's saying.
Yes. How can you be in pieces?
That Allah also refers to the Quran as the book. Yes. But when you talk about it in context, are you telling me the Quran is saying, so woe to those who write the Quran with their own hands and then say, this is from Allah? No, it's talking about the people of the book. Oh. So when Allah says here, and the tafsir of this verse is talking
tafsir.
About the Jews who used to distort it. Look.
Whoa.
They're talking about the Jews. Will you show me the tafsir? I need that one.
Yes.
Look, do you know the Jews? Do you know the Jews believe in the Torah?
Can I speak?
No, you can speak. Yeah. But wait, you know the Jews believe in the Torah and the Talmud. So is this talking about Torah or Talmud?
Brother, you know it's very clearly that it's talking about the book. Woe
I know
those who write with their own hands. Who does this?
Talmud is written
did
in their
I,
own
did
hands.
Did I interrupt you when you was
Talmud
speaking?
Talmud is written
did
in their own hands.
Did I interrupt you when you was talking? No.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, so learn to be silent.
Well, how did you come in here
2 years,
when I'm speaking to Adnan?
Okay. Adnan, when now I'm talking, okay? I don't know why you're so stuck with that. Okay, let's move on. You got to move on in life.
Listen, you're going to have your own journal.
No problem, we'll see. So when it says, so woe to those who write the scriptures with their own hands, who can Allah be talking to? Who has Allah always been talking about? The people of the book for what? Doing what? Always distorting, always changing. Like the brother said, when the verse that you're talking about where it says an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, who is he talking about there? He's talking about the Jews who came to the Prophet and they looked into their scripture and said, damn, we're in trouble. Because over here it says the adulterers have to be stoned to death. So they're like, you know what? We know. We'll find a little exit. How? We'll go to the Prophet Muhammad. They didn't believe he was a prophet. We'll go to him and let him judge. Yeah, so we can escape our test, the Bible, yeah, the Old Testament. So they went to the Prophet and the Prophet said, why are you coming to me? What does it say in your book? He said, open it. And what were they doing? They were covering the verse. And he said, move your finger. Like my man, you need to learn that as well, yeah? And they said, what does it say there? The boss punishment for adultery. It said, stoning. It said, stone them to death. So, you come in and using this argument, you don't understand. So, you're using it against yourself. Here, it's clearly talking about them changing the scriptures, covering the scriptures for their benefit, their own benefit. So, when Allah's talking about this verse here, so woe to them, who is it talking about? Let's see, okay, not the Christians, not the Jews. Who's it talking about?
Are you finished?
Yeah.
You finished there?
Yeah? Sure. Answer this question.
It's very, very funny how Ali Dawah talks everything without reference.
He hasn't
don't interrupt.
Oh, stop heckling.
No heckling. No heckling.
Stop heckling.
No heckling, mister.
I know. Where you were talking,
I know in Islam, you don't have patience.
Brother, please.
Where you were talking,
Ali Dawah said.
Ali
Dawah said.
Leave Ali Dawah said.
Ali Dawah said. For the sake of Ali Dawah, just be quiet.
So why is he telling you to be quiet? Come on, man. Be quiet.
It's very funny that Ali Dawah blabs on without a Ali Dawah, without a reference. Surah 279 is talking about the Jews writing with their own hands, but it does not talk about Torah or Injil or Talmud. It doesn't. Now, it's an onus on you, the onus on you to show me the proof that Surah 279 is referring to the Torah. Okay. However, let's read the context of Surah 279. Let's start from 77. Do they not know that Allah knows whatever they hide and whatever they disclose? And among them are the illiterate who know nothing of the book except hearsay and only make conjecture. Now, it's the people, the problem, not the book.
Uh-huh.
You see this? Yeah. This is what the Quran says.
Yes.
But Ali Dawah conveniently ignores Surah 278. And then he talks about his own tafsir. I think he is like a scholar or something. Are you a scholar? Yeah? You need to show me reference. Ibn Abbas, Ibn Kathir, Al Jalalain. Show me reference. Don't just talk from your own mind.
Nothing. He's a YouTube scholar.
YouTube scholar. Surah 279. So woe to those who write the book with their hands and then say this is from Allah. What book is Allah talking about? Oh, is he talking about Talmud? Is he talking about Torah? Quran or Injil? What book is he talking about? The Quran is not clear. So you go to the tafsir and it's about the Jews. Yeah? But the Jews believed in the Talmud and the Torah. So how do we know this is about the Torah? How do we know that? So answer the question clear and concise. Show me the reference where this is referring to the book of the Torah.
Very good, very good.
Finish? I am. Okay. Go for it.
So the question I asked was this, yeah? If Allah is not referring to, because Allah's not going to refer to the Quran, because it's contradiction. If Allah said, woe to those who write the Quran with their own hands and say this is from Allah, it's the contradiction. So he's saying, how prove to me, Ali, that he's talking about the Christian and the Jews, yeah? I'm seeing arguments saying, no problem.
You said
how is it, where does it say Torah or Injil? Did you not say that to
Torah and Injil.
Exactly, so
yeah.
Then why are you saying you didn't?
I didn't say Jews.
I mean, no, the Torah and the Injil,
yeah.
Okay, so I'm saying if Allah is not talking about the Quran, come be talking about the Quran, no problem. The only book that we know that was sent before is the Zabur, the Injil, and the Torah. So if it's not talking about the Quran, You tell me, okay, it's not the Torah, it's not the Injil. Who's it talking about? Who's Allah talking about? And then when he made the point, he said that it's not the book that's corrupt, it's the people. Did he not say that?
I didn't say that. That's what 78 says.
Okay.
Okay, so read what 78 says.
So the 78 Allah say, Allah does not say that it's the people that are corrupt, yeah? Okay,
your book says, can
the book corrupt its own self? Who does it need?
Allah's wrong.
Okay, let's repeat that again. Can the book corrupt itself? Can the book say I'm gonna...
You're gonna repeat my name a lot,
don't worry.
Don't worry.
We'll let people decide, yeah? So, the people are the ones that do the corruption. The book cannot say, hey, like John chapter 73, Mark 11, it doesn't belong here anymore. Yeah, or this verse, it doesn't belong. The people do it. So who's Allah talking? To the people. Because the people are the ones that's changing it, yes? And like I said to you before, the tafsir of this verse is talking about the Jews.
There was
who were the first Christians?
That show us the proof.
They were Jews.
Show us the proof.
Okay.
No proof.
I'm getting it right
no
now.
Proof.
But you tell me, if it's not talking about the Torah or Injil, who is it talking about? Who else does Allah mention in the Quran? Does it talk about the Hindus? Does it talk about their scripture? No, it doesn't. So my question is this. The argument saying it's not the Injil, it's not the Torah. Who is it talking about? Answer.
Okay. It's very, very clear, yeah? If I concede this debate, saying this is talking about the Torah and the Injil, if I concede it, yeah, I lost. However, there's a problem in the Quran if that is the case. It's not the case. I've proved that it's not the case. It could be about the Talmud or the Torah, we don't know. But if that is the case, there's a problem in the Quran. Surah 3, Ayah 3 clearly says the Torah and the Injil is revealed from Allah. Surah 18:27 says, no one can change the words of Allah.